Later on, I got here. The most important thing is that 42 liters.
So let's say that eternal eye. So that that could imply the eye of the secret soul in him.
No, no, eternal is from the supreme divine.
Okay,
eye.
Sir. Okay, sir. So he.
You know, his eyesight is not getting identified with the divine eye.
Right, sir. But that would be if his consciousness is getting identified.
No, no, it is as a person. Consciousness is not, is a, the senses have now awakened to that faculty. You see, the active senses are not, consciousness is a different thing. No, the physical senses now have become alert, they have become subtle, and they are able to see all the shades and nuances of the whole thing, you see. And when he is catching for the eternal eye, it means that his sight now has become so perceptive that it is as if the divine eye itself is seeing the whole thing. It is not just consciousness, the physical senses, the organs have become alert, perceptive from the point of view. But what is your question there?
Sir, the question was just what specifically is the eternal eye intended for? That was the only question, sir. Because, I mean, eternal eye would be the eye within, which is out of time.
See, the, for the eternal eye, it is always there. But now, it is the identification of his faculties.
Now, for example, sir, he is indicated that his consciousness has
mind. No, I will not go by consciousness here. These are physical organs, eye, speech, hearing, all
no,
this.
Sir, it's, I'm just speaking from the perspective. Let's say if we do take it as a consciousness aspect,
okay,
then he's just presenting what the physical eye is seeing to the consciousness.
He is seeing with the subtle eye, which
right,
is the eye behind the eye. What the Upanishad would say, the eye behind the eye.
Right.
And behind that eye is manasa. Behind that manasa is sadhyana. Means the faculty of what you would call the apprehending faculty of things has waken up in him. What is called sadhyana, it is that apprehending faculty which has now started operating in him. And therefore, that means it is not just an objective world which I am seeing. I am seeing what is there behind the objective world. It is not that this is a piece of this is a table. It is not that I am seeing it as a table. It is something behind me which is seeing it as a table. It is not a physical eye. In other words, even if I close my eyes, physical eyes, still I will be able to see the table. Still I will be able to see the table, you see.
Right, sir.
The eye behind the eye has opened out and is able to see the objective world also, you see. It is an organ which has weakened up, you see, not just the consciousness, you see. And that is what you would call sadhyana. There are four types of knowledge. So it is that which has now wakened up in him, you see. He is, in other words, this is an indicative description of his subtle faculties which are fully developed. And then later on he says, because all these things have happened here, I felt a covered touch. He is talking of eye, he is talking of listening, he is talking of touch. All these subtle faculties are there.
Right.
Pancha Mahabhutas, they have become the sukshma elements of recognition. And then later on, therefore he says, I sat with the forest sages in the trance. 42.
Yes, sir.
There poured awaking streams of diamond light. See, he is already seeing the diamond light rushing into him, streams, constant flow in the company of those sages. I glimpsed the presence of one in all. Now that is a great, great spiritual experience, great spiritual realization. Everywhere, in all the objects, trees, mountains, birds, flowers, animals, beasts, even sages, everybody. Whom do I see? I see them one, 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 only one. This is the experience of what the later traditions would call that Vasudeva is everywhere.
Yes, sir. What Shivabindu had
what
in the jail.
Had. Vasudeva is everywhere. So he is already having that kind of an experience. I claim the presence of the one in all. Yeah, Shivabindu says, in the jailer, in the prisoners,
yes, sir.
With the people that are around, yes, I see the only thing but Vasudeva, yes. Vasudeva is here. Then he says, yes, it's a great realization. It is the dynamic realization, but still there lack the last transcendent power. I was still feeling something amiss, something not complete. Why? And matter still slept empty of its Lord. Yes, material world, it is not yet awakened to its own reality, to its own truth, what it is here for. And then he says, the most important, the spirit was saved, the body lost and mute, you still with death and ancient ignorance. So he has come now to the basic realization that, all right, I have all those great spiritual realizations, great spiritual experience, self, Atman, even beyond that, yes, all those passive Brahman, active Brahman, yes, but then finally what happens to my body? The crux of the problem lies in the body. Body is subject to death and ignorance, and he is haunted by that problem. Is there something which can be done for the body? Or is that body going to be in that condition of slavery or subjection to death and ignorance all along? That is his dilemma now. In fact, he has become alert most of the time. It may be too smart on our part to say that he said, I sat with the forest sages in their trance and diamond light poured into him. Obviously, the sages also had the diamond light. But did the sages feel that the body still lived with death and ancient ignorance?
Were they compelled to tackle that problem? Is the question.
No, but did they even think in that way? Did they even perceive in that way? Did they feel that difficulty at all? Or it is something unique to Satyavan in the company of all of them? Does it stand out against all those spiritual giants, greats? That they perhaps have not realized the necessity of looking at the body also as a possibility of opening to the spirit.
Right.
But he feels that something is lacking. So I would say that even at that moment of time, there is something in Satyavan which is different from the other great spiritual personalities. It is he who is feeling that. And then he says, live still with death and in ancient ignorance. The inconscient was its base, the void is fate. Most of the time, in all these traditions, all the great rishis, they perhaps recognize that there is a problem with the body. But then finally, what they did? Okay, let's forget the body and get out of it here and attain immortality elsewhere. Body was left as it is, abundant. This man, this young person, he says, no, there is something which has got to be done also for the body. And he's looking for a solution. He's in a quest. And then this girl comes, so to say.
As a solution.
Pardon?
As a solution.
Yes, that's right. This is what I could say. Thou hast come and all will surely change. I shall feel the world mother in the golden lane and hear her wisdom in the sacred voice.
Now this is the important line, sir, which is coming
yeah,
next.
The child, the void, shall be reborn in God.
So here the transformation theme is kind
of. The possibilities of the body.
He's already seeing the transformation of the body.
Yeah, that's right.
So he's worrying about that.
That's important. The child of the void. In fact, this is universal as well as individual. Universal, child of the void, the entire creation which has sprung up from void, shall be reborn in God. Individual, and I would say perhaps this is a personal note and not a universal note which Satyavan is striking here. He is striking an individual note, not so much perhaps a universal note.
He's in his own, he's all by his own self.
Yeah.
I mean, he is.
No, because after all, so to say, we know. I mean, the mother has spoken about Satyavan. Who is Satyavan? Satyavan is the permanent avatar in the void. Right. He is the child of the void there. Right. And it is that Satyavan who has to be reborn in God. That rebirth of Satyavan in God is what is going to happen in through the work of Savitri. So in that sense, it is contextual, more contextual than I will say universal.
Right.
The child, although it, I mean, it does, certainly it has a universal implication, but the occult charge here is Satyavan, who has taken a permanent station in the void, and in order that he should be reborn, something must happen, and that something which is going to happen is what is being described here. He has recognized. See, amongst all of them, why only Satyavan recognizes, not the other sees?
Right, sir.
Because he is the child of the void.
Right,
sir. See, in that sense, you see.
Right.
In that sense.
So that psychic being in him is kind of realizes that necessity of getting an appropriate body in that
sense. No, but psychic being, Rishis also had psychic being, you see,
sir. But having is one thing, but sir, being seized of the of its own problem is another.
Mm-hmm.
In that sense.
Such as?
I mean, the psychic being, when it is worrying about the body for its own this thing.
No, it is not psychic being. There is something in him, in his soul itself, which recognizes that.
Right, sir.
He recognizes that, you see. So, the child of the void reborn in God. Now you have got.
And he also says, sir, shall
in
be.
In the next line.
No, sir, he says, no, he doesn't say could be, he says shall be.
Shall be, obviously. Why? Shall be reborn.
He has the confidence to.
Yeah, but he is a little cautious, that's all, you see.
Yes,
see, in fact, if you. Now that you are pointing out this one, now the child, the void, shall be reborn. Shall be, yes, it will happen.
Sir. It will happen. So he has, he is confirming.
See, that is what I am saying. Earlier you had no here. We have got, see, the 45, first line.
Yes,
but
sir.
Thou has come and all will surely change. See, something in him has recognized in her that, yes, this is the power who can really do something in the context of the body.
Right.
Surely. And the shall again, you see. That is true. And then later on, of course, you have got.
Then there is this other conversation that
see,
starts.
In this line, he says, bodies, so basically the whole problem is you shall escape from death and ignorance. Now, this is something little worrying. My body, like my spirit, shall be free. It shall escape from death and ignorance.
Yes.
Now that escape, what does that mean?
Escape from death, sir, would again maybe has the sense of deathlessness, wherein, I mean.
No, but again, ignorance is combined with ignorance, you see.
He said that is again Satyavan's own reality.
No, but he says escape.
Now that is another thing, sir. Whether it means escape from death.
Yeah, I mean, again, he also goes because you see
Yes, sir.
that. Or, but it is in the manner of English language. Escape means body will not be anymore subject to death and ignorance.
Right, sir. It has to be that. It can't be escaping.
Escape in that sense, body will not be anymore
Yes, sir.
subject to death and ignorance.
Is it because it's the context is defined by my body,
Yeah, exactly.
like my spirit shall be
Yeah,
free.
yeah.
So it's the context is clearly.
Yeah,
In
that's
that
right.
case, it should have been only my spirit shall be free.
Yeah.
Now then, Savitri
Savitri
again asks
knows
her
the
a specific
convo.
question. He's answered her questions, the previous one which she had asked. Now
Now,
she.
Savitri is saying something interesting here. Speak more to me. Speak more. Oh, Satyavan. You find musical? Name Satyavan. Okay. Speak of thyself and all thou art, etc., etc. She says, thyself and all thou art
Within.
within. In other words, the
So,
problem of body.
yes, sir, which you had earlier mentioning that there is a certain realization in his being, there is something else in his being which is not there in
Others, exactly.
others.
That's what she's saying.
So
It is
she,
confirmed by her.
yes, sir, she now confirms that and she says you elaborate more on that.
Yeah, that's right.
Yes,
Yeah,
sir.
that's right. Yeah. And then she says, I would know thee as if we had ever lived
Lived together.
together. Now, in the chamber of where? Of course, the chamber
Of
of
our
our
souls,
souls. We have been living together since ages and ages and all that. This is what she said. Does it mean that I would know thee as if we had, as of course, this as if is a way of speaking. It means,
yes, sir.
yes, surely we have lived together.
Yes, sir.
You see. Now, this awakening of.
No, sir. This as if could also imply that the when the soul completely flows into the another soul, then you completely identified, then you would it would seem that you've lived together all this while.
Yeah, but then, live together is different. It is not that it is dissolving one into the other.
Yes, sir, that is there. But I mean, in this context, this could be the context that I want to know you from your very essence of your being. I want to identify with that. So it could be in that sense also
As if.
that as if is in that context, sir. Not specifically confirming or not confirming the fact that they've lived together or not earlier.
Yeah, but here the rather it is more emphasizing that yes, we have you together.
So then just see the next 49. Speak till a light shall come into my heart. So she specifically says, now you elaborate about yourself, and in your elaboration, go to the point till a light comes in me and I realize and I would understand what the all the deathless being in me feels.
But you see, now there is a difference there. In the first case, together in the chamber of our souls.
Yes, sir.
Now here, souls, yes, we are together. But now, with the veil of human personalities around us, you speak till that veil gets removed. See, it is even the outward form, that sort of an identification of that oneness has to be realized, not only in the soul. See, earlier she says, our souls.